back again. I hope you kids had a great weekend. Hope you guys had a great week. Hope you've been praying and reading your Bibles, and I hope you're ready, because here we go. Alright, was that a great worship service or what? Now on to our verse. Now I know that our verses have been pretty long and pretty hard to remember, but this one's pretty short and really important, and I'm almost certain that all you kids know it, and if you don't know it, then you should really try everything you can to know it. So, without further ado, our verse is Deuteronomy 6:4.
Hello friends, this is your verse of the week. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Deuteronomy 6:4.
All right, kids. So what I have for us today is vola. Right here. Anyone know what this is? That's right, it's a napkin. But today, this is going to represent us. It's going to represent me. It's going to represent you at home. It's going to represent our parents. It's going to represent all of us. And what I want to talk about today is how life could be really difficult and really hard a lot of times, especially right now during all the quarantine, not being able to go outside. So right now, this is us, right? And these are just the trials that life can offer us. So let's say, you know, we could get our heart broken. Let's say the adversary could come against us and, you know, we could become sad, maybe about our friends don't want to be our friends. Other things that can come against us, all the possible things that can just make life really hard and really difficult. And they can then begin to just break us down, whether it's disappointments, setbacks, you know, and all those other things that can just come against us where we're just sad and life can just be hard. And things just not working out the way we want to and all that other stuff. And so, you see, we can just begin to just let all that stuff just build up and just kind of get to us. And then before you know it, we're all just broken up completely, just like this. And now, looking at our life, it can be pretty tough because it's all just in pieces. But you know what? For us, it doesn't have to stay that way. It doesn't have to stay like this because we can take our lives, we can take the pieces of our lives and the hard parts in our life, and we can give them to who? Who can we give them to? That's right, we can give them to Jesus. So we bring these to Jesus and say, look at Jesus, here's my life. Here's everything I'm going through. Here's all the hard points. And take something and do with it. And he can take it, he can put it in his hands, and he can begin to work it. And he can be able to do something with our lives, something great with our lives that no one else can do, that there's no person on this earth that can do this for us. Doesn't matter who they are, like from, you know, all the way up to the most important person in the world to the least important person in the world. Nobody can put our lives back together like Jesus, especially when we place them in his hands. So we put our hands in Jesus and we say, you know what? We're going to lean on you, Jesus. We're going to allow you to work in our lives. We're going to put all of our cares and concerns in your hands and let you deal with it. And then what can happen and what will happen is if we lean on Jesus, put our lives in his hands, is before you know it, pretty soon, we'll take a look at it. And all of that disappointment and all of that heartache and all of that hard things in our lives will actually be what? Be what? It'll be back together again. It'll be whole. Jesus will have taken all those broken parts of our life and seemingly mend us back together. There's so many countless stories in the Bible of Jesus making people whole, and even in our personal lives, our own personal testimonies. And myself, my wife, and many more included can attestament to the miraculous power that Jesus has for restoring lives. So I just want to remind you kids on this Sunday that we have, especially with all of the hard stuff going on, with all of our cares, with all of our issues, with all of whatever may be bringing us up and down, that we can take these things to Jesus, put them in his hands, and believe that he, and only he, is going to be able to fix them and put everything back together. All right, kids, I want to close with prayer. So everybody bow their heads real quick. Mighty Jesus, we come before you. I'm asking that you keep your hand upon every kid, upon every family, dear Jesus, and everyone in this church, every member. I'm asking you to watch over us during this time of difficulty. Comfort us, give us strength, and push us further every day. In Jesus' name. All right, kids, I want to encourage you. Remember, read your scripture, Deuteronomy 6:4. Read your Bible this week. Remember to pray. Remember to talk about Jesus. We love you, kids. We're praying for you, kids. And hope you guys have a great week. Until next time, see you then.